Our next guest this morning comes with a mission. Creative Business School Hyper Island brings transformative education to the Philippines, offering programs that will help learners meet the demands of the digital world. And we're now joined by Peachy Paking. She's the managing director of Hyper Island Asia Pacific. Peachy, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen. It's a pleasure to be here.
All right. And same with you. All right. Let's talk about this. What is Hyper Island and what kind of school is this?
All right. That's a good question. Sometime back 25 years ago, three educators said there's no school that responds to the convergence of media, business and technology. So they created one, and that's Hyper Island. So we sit at the center of business, technology, and creativity. So that's the school in terms of pillars. Those are the three pillars that that prop up the school. So that was 25 years ago. We were founded in Karlskrona, Sweden. And now we have hubs in Europe, the Americas, North and South America, and Asia Pacific. And finally, Hyper Island is now in the Philippines, because this has always been my dream ever since I went to Hyper Island as a student. I am a graduate of Hyper Island.
Okay. So Hyper Island has how many branches technically worldwide?
Oh, we have what we call hubs. So we have three hubs. There's the European hub, which covers most of the Nordic countries, as well as Switzerland, and I think the United Kingdom. And then we have another hub in the Americas, which covers Brazil, New York, I think, and I think Miami. I think there's a in Miami. And then we have another one in Asia Pacific, and that is headquartered in Singapore. And we have a representation in Japan, as well as and currently the Philippines. So those are the schools right now.
Okay, so you have opened, actually you launched yesterday in the Philippines. And what kind of courses can you take in Hyper Island if you enroll? And what is the age group? Who can enroll for a Hyper Island course?
All right, the flagship program of Hyper Island Asia Pacific is its master's program. It's a master's in digital management, and we call it...
technically, I can enroll.
Anyone can enroll.
I mean, right? Master's, that you have to be a college graduate, tama? No.
No.
Ano? Hindi no. To yung typical master's.
No, this is an academic degree. It's
an
academic
degree.
Yeah, so it's an academic degree. You will get a academic degree from Hyper Island, and it is a certified course by Teesside University. That's in the UK. Why do I say you don't necessarily have to have a college degree? It's because we look at your profile, and if you have anywhere a substantial amount of industry practice, that's taken into consideration with your academic credentials. So it's not just you. It's not just a prerequisite of you having a college degree, therefore you must be able to have substantial industry practice so you may contribute to the conversations during your courses.
Yeah.
So yes, for sure, Karen. If you decide to go back to school, more than happy to have you.
Technically speaking, Hyper Island is only accepting those who are practicing.
We accept everyone. We accept people who are on academic track, meaning people who'd like to take the bachelor's, the master's, and eventually a PhD. And we also accept people who probably have gotten up to bachelor's or perhaps maybe one year shy. But then it becomes case to case, and we have an interview, and we ask you, so what have you done, and why are you here? So it's a far more flexible way of getting a master's degree.
But is this a typical master's degree? Like, for example, is this a master's degree that you would get, for example, if you apply out of college. Is it similar?
Yes, it is. It is. Okay. It's the master's everybody knows and is familiar with.
Yeah. But then a typical master's degree, you need to be a college graduate.
That's
the difference.
That's the traditional way of looking at it. And I guess when you ask me, if you ask me what makes Hyper Island different, is we really look at people's contributions into the workplace. And therefore, we have the prerogative to say that you have reached a certain level of academic, you have a certain academic credential, but your practice actually qualifies you for a master's.
Because I agree, experience is actually the stronger teacher. Sa totoo lang, diba?
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. So all over the world, how many students have graduated from Hyper Island?
Oh, the last count, I think we announced we had about 10,000 learners and counting. So we've been around for quite some time. Maybe I'm underrepresenting it.
Yeah.
So, but because we also do corporate trainings, because as a school, corporations come to us and say, we have a challenge in, like, say, employer retention, or we have a challenge in business transformation. Yes. And so they come to us and we do have consultancy services, but the difference between a regular consultancy and a consultancy that's a school is that we don't give you the answers. We take you through the learning so you may be able to answer your challenges in the future. So we teach you how to fish as opposed to giving you the fish.
Okay. So it says here essentially that you could be, for example, a systems connector, a rapid adapter, a confident teamer, playful explorer, tech wrangler, reflective storyteller. What are these phrases? I mean, they're quite uniquely yours. What do you mean by these?
These are qualities of a Hyper Island person. So if you leave our program, you have the ability to exhibit or manifest these qualities. There is a lot of discussion right now about the lack of soft skills in the graduates and them not being able to find jobs. Our point of view is you may call them soft skills, but they're actually harder skills to facilitate, because it's fairly easy to teach you the hard skills, but soft skills need to be facilitated more than taught. So it's not easy to teach soft skills. So those characteristics that you've mentioned, they're largely in the soft skills area, because it's about curiosity, it's about courage. And you can teach people how to code, but you can't really teach people how to be courageous.
Mm.
So, and that's what we need. We need moving into the future.
Okay, so I'm curious, it says here that you offer ground training for individuals and organizations. Your online programs right now, no? So you have a digital management accelerator program. And what does that cover, right?
Okay.
Because there's also a master's program in digital management.
Yes, I talked about the master's earlier. Now, the digital management accelerator program is the best of the master's in 12 weeks. So if you remember, in the olden days, you would have the best of
whoever. So I can enroll.
Of course.
Okay.
Of course.
Yes. And online lang lahat to.
Yes, but
it's 3 months, tama, no?
The DMAP, the Digital Acceleration Program, is 12 weeks.
12 weeks, 3 months?
Yes, 12 weeks. Oh, yes, it's almost 3 months.
Okay.
But it is online. Most of our courses are online, except the master's program, which is held in Singapore. However, if there is a demand and people would like to have face-to-face classes, that can easily be arranged. Mm-hmm. We have a crew. We call them crew. We have a group of people who are capable of facilitating the courses here in the Philippines.
Yes, we do. Where will you do it?
That's nice. That's a nice question, because we are what we call an asset light school, meaning we don't have a brick and mortar school. We can teach anywhere. You know, if you say come to the company and come facilitate learning in our boardroom, or perhaps we can go into a co-working space, or perhaps just last night we were at the yard at Menarca Tower. So we can teach anywhere. It's really about the interactions that you create, not necessarily the four walls of a classroom, right? Mm-hmm. So yes, we can come and run the classes here. But largely, our courses right now are virtual. Yeah.
Okay. So that's 3 weeks, but the master's program itself, that in Singapore.
And yes, how long is that? It's 18 weeks. And when I took it, I was living in the Philippines and I was retired. And I said that surely there's something else to do after retirement. So I went back to school and I flew to Singapore every 6 weeks.
Oh, okay. But then there is an 18 months executive level program.
That will is be the master's.
Not 18 weeks then, 18 months.
The master's is an executive level master's, which is 18 months. And the acceleration program is 12 weeks.
Okay. All right. So I think in the Philippines, since you've already launched this, you can speak to the audience. Who are you targeting? I know the applications are open right now. It's open, or it'll be open on May 15th.
Yes. The next cohort, the next master's cohort is going to start in mid-July. Applications are ongoing, so just reach out to us. Look for us at hyperisland.com, very easy to remember. And to your question of who could come and who is invited to join the program, I think we think more in terms of psychographics than demographics. I think if you're ready for a change, if you feel like you're in entering a transition phase, whether you feel that your current role in corporate is no longer challenging you, or perhaps you feel like you would like to go into entrepreneurship instead, or generally people who just wonder what's out there and what's for me, how can I participate in the conversations, because it seems like the conversations are changing and my vocabulary seems to be stuck in the 20th century. Okay. Yeah. So just for anyone who feels that they need some level of transformation. So if that resonates with anyone out there, then please, by all means, please check out our website at hyperisland.com.
Okay, this is brilliant. Thank you so much for sharing this today, Peachy. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much for having me. Thank you, Karen.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too.